Welcome back to another Digital No-Brainer, the series where we look at quick and easy wins in online marketing. Today we're going to look at MailChimp forms. Forms where people can fill in their details and agree to be contacted by you for email marketing purposes. This is very relevant right now because the GDPR regulations, the data protection regs, on May the 25th will prohibit you from contacting people in a marketing sense unless they've specifically agreed to hear from you about certain topics. I'm going to get straight into the screen and show you how to do it. So as an example of one that works, this is an email I sent out recently for our business, and this is the important bit. When you create a MailChimp form, it creates a link. I can put on anything, Facebook, social media, emails, anything. And that's what I sent my existing customer list. I said, look, I'm an ethical business. I cannot communicate with you after May the 25th without having evidence that you've signed up to hear from me for these purposes. I send them this email, they click it, takes them straight to the sign-up form, and I want to highlight one particular aspect, this bit. Choices about the different topics they want to hear from you about. That is a GDPR requirement. Of course, one of mine is everything. All updates. I'm going to show you how to set that up. So if I close that down, this is the MailChimp screen. This is what you'll see when you log in. MailChimp's a free piece of software if you have less than 2,000 emails. And lists in the menu up here is the part we want to use. I click lists and it will open up my default list. Business Think Digital is the name of mine. You can call or name or create any list you like. We then click that list to open up the screen and the menu for those details. When I click manage contacts, you'll see an element called groups. They are subsets of lists. And if I come down here, you'll see I've set some up. If I view the groups, there are different topics for my mailing list, which we will be using. I can add a new one. If I add a new group, I'm going to add digital news and save. You must create those subsections so that people can choose what topics they want to hear from you about. Once I've set up my groups, I then just quickly click sign up forms. There's the form builder. I select form builder and automatically my form is ready. Here is that email address that we're going to use in a minute and I'll show you how quick and easy it is. When I scroll down, there's default boxes. I've added my logo. You just do that by clicking a box up here saying add image instead of text. I've edited this box to say this is what this is about. It's about GDPR. Then I have these default fields. Email address, first name, last name, phone number. And here are my subset groups that people will click. And when they click subscribe, they're on the list automatically. I don't have to do anything else. To show you that in practice, if I paste the link into my browser, here it is, ready to go, live. As soon as they hit subscribe to the list, they are on my mailing list. They are GDPR compliant because I have evidence of sign up. Thanks for watching. If you enjoyed this video and found it useful, please do leave a thumbs up. If it's the first time you've watched one of my videos, then please do subscribe. I'll be making these videos on a regular basis. And thanks for watching.